much for joining us. We do have the link to the presentation on the slide, and the link will be put in the chat as well. As you noticed when you came in, you are on mute and your cameras are off. However, at the end of the session, we will turn on, allow you to unmute if you would like to ask questions, but you can type those at any time during the chat to help you. So I would like to go ahead and talk about, we're going to talk about reports, staff evaluations, reports you can find in your dashboard, and quick reports. And I will be presenting today. And this target audience for this particular presentation is district administrators, site administrators, and principals. If you are not in any of those roles, you probably won't be able to do a lot of what we're sharing today. You're always welcome to stay, but just be aware you may not have rights depending on what your roles are in NESIS. So my name is Donna Curry, and I am the NESIS and OER product manager. And we do have some people here who are going to help. So I will let you both introduce yourselves.
Good afternoon. I'm Jennifer Bass. I work very closely with Donna and Cammy. I am the NESIS consultant. If you have any questions considering policy with NESIS, I'm the person that you contact. Thank you for joining this afternoon.
Hi all, and I am Cammy Nairn. I am now the Assistant PowerSchool SIS Product Manager, previously the NESIS Product Manager. So I am assisting Donna as we transition into new roles. So I hope you guys have a great webinar.
And I am going to go ahead and just cut my camera off just because sometimes it does help with bandwidth and helps with slowness as we're presenting. But thank you for joining us again today. So what we're going to talk about today in our agenda is we're going to talk about reports from staff evaluations. We're going to talk about reports from staff dashboard, and we're going to also be talking about some quick reports and reporting that you can find from the reporting tab. This does align to the digital learning plan in the categories of human capacity and leadership and vision. So if you want to refer back to the digital learning plan, you may do that. That is linked here as well. Do you have a plan for running your reports? If you do not have a plan for running your reports, these are some things you might want to think about that would be very helpful as you are progressing throughout the school year. So who runs your report? NESIS district administrators, your NESIS site administrators. Site administrators who are principal can run reports on all staff in their location. Site administrators who are APs or other roles, reports for results will be restricted by their access rights. And that's kind of what I was saying about your access rights in NESIS will determine if this session is beneficial to you or not. So those are some things to think about. Also, who keeps a record of your evaluations and your PDP when your staff leave your site? Once a staff leave your site, you no longer have access to those evaluations because they do go with the person and you can't see those anymore. So you might want to think about having a plan of making a copy of those before you leave. They leave because once they leave, you cannot access those again because the plans do belong to the individual, and when they leave, they follow them. Also, some things to think about is how often does your administration want to see a percentage of plan activity completions? Is this something they want to see on a monthly basis? Is this something they have to have before they have principal meetings or things like that? So think about how often, and there are reports that we can schedule or teach you how to schedule so they'll have access to that when they do meet. And who can run all the needed reports before the end of the school year? We are asking that everything be run on June 28th this year, since that is a Friday and June 30th is on a Sunday. So we're trying to make sure you have everything done before you leave that weekend. And who's going to run all those needed reports? And we'll share some reports that are going to be beneficial to run at different times of the year. And a question is, can you just run a report from a past year? And technically, yes, but those reports are not going to have exactly what you need. When you run a report from a previous year, if you need the person's location, you need their plan type, or even their name if they have changed their name, that information is pulled from current information. So it will not be correct historical data if you do pull a report that is from a previous year. So it's very needed that you run all of the reports before this school year is over, because if you pull reports, that historical information will not be correct. So did you know that plans have to be in active status before they are running on NESIS report. So people have to start their plan. They have to start their plan before they appear on staff evaluation site. They have to start their plan before they appear on reports. If you have someone who is not appearing on the staff evaluation screen, if you were to go to My Staff and then go to All Staff and click the drop down beside their name, if you see the word start, that means they have not started their plan, and therefore that plan is not going to appear on your report. If you see the word edit, that means they have started their plan. So make sure you are in communication with your staff about making sure they are starting those plan types at the beginning of school. They actually need to click on My Evaluation. They actually need to start new. They need to start that plan so they will appear on your report. After they start, you can see their status along the way, but making sure that they do click start. So that's going to be something that will be helpful for you to make sure that that is going on. So making sure they are starting. So let's talk, first of all, we're going to talk about a few different reports that you can run. And the first one we're going to talk about is from staff evaluation report. So when you are in NESIS and you are on the staff evaluation screen, there's a couple of reports that you can run here. You're going to look first for that download CSV. And download CSV is going to pull what is currently on the dashboard. So your filters are going to come in very handy for you if you're looking for certain information. And we'll talk about those filters in just a second. The evaluation completion report is going to pull with all the information that's on the staff evaluation page. It's not narrowed down by school or by plan or anything like that. But it will pull it in, and you can filter that when you are on, you know, filter in Excel or Google Sheets, you can filter it there. Some of our larger districts have told us that when you download CSV, it will only pull in 500 records at a time. So if you're in a larger district, you're probably really going to want to use your filters to maybe pull in one plan at a time to make sure that you're not losing any information. So just being aware of your limits there and being aware of what you are seeing. So when we look at those staff evaluations at CSV, so the purpose of that is to allow you to filter that staff dashboard and then create a report based on the activity completion and then download that. After today, if you do have any questions, you'll see that there is a video here that's going to guide you through that. So if you just want to go back to this particular section, you can do that. So let's go look to the live site at downloading that. Okay, so from staff evaluations, and you will see that I am impersonating a training account, so occasionally my site might look slightly different than yours, but when we are on this slide, you're going to see that I do have some staff members. Those two icons that I showed you that you would want to look at, the download CSV and the little reporting icon. Like I said, we'll look at that one second. You're going to make sure that on this field, if I were to click download CSV right now, it's going to show me everybody that I have on this screen. So what I can do is I can work with filters. If you've never worked with filters, they are very helpful. So I'm just going to click add filter. And some things that you can filter for is you can filter by if a plan is archived, you can filter by owner name. You might want to filter by active plan. You can filter by PDP self-assessment. Anyway, so these are some options. I'm going to click active plan. And I want my active plan to be equal to, and then you can choose your plan type. So maybe I want this report just to pull abbreviated plans. After you add any filters, you do need to update your table. And you can add more than one filter. So if you wanted to look at certain things within this plan, I'm going to add another filter. And maybe I want to see if they have done their training and orientation. And I want that to be equal to completed. So I'm going to update my table. And this is going to give me a list of people who have done that training and orientation. And think of where you're at in the school year and when what things you need to look for. Since we're more middle of the year, I probably could have pulled a different report. But this is going to give you some data that you can pull. And now when I download CSV, only those filters that I applied will appear. So those filters are very, very helpful. If you wanted to, I'm going to just remove my filters to get everybody back. So in addition to the CSV, You also have the option to run the evaluation completion report, and that is found by clicking on this little zigzag, that little graph icon. And the evaluation completion report is going to easily show plan activity completion. It's going to show assigned plans. It's going to show unstarted plans, but only if they have started something. If they have started their PDP, but not their teacher plan type, they will appear on this form. If they have started their teacher plan type, but not their vice versa, what I just said, if they've started at least one, then this plan will pull their status in all plans. But they have to start something to be triggered on this page. So let's look at how we get to that. Once again, we're going to go to our staff evaluations tab. We're going to click on that graph icon. So we're going to do that together. After today, if you want to go look at steps just to do this step without watching the whole presentation, there is a video here that you can look at to do that. So once again, I'm going to go back to NESIS. I'm going to go back to staff evaluation. I'm going to remove any filters that I might have and just update my table. I'm going to click on this little reporting menu icon and click evaluation completion. First thing you're going to need to do once you get here is you're going to need to choose your plan. So you can see one plan at a time. I'm going to choose the abbreviated evaluation. And then I'm going to look at one information I want. These are all of the containers that are required, or not maybe not required, but are in the abbreviated plan. I don't need all of those at this time, so I'm just going to deselect. And I'm thinking at this point in the school year that we probably need to be through about evaluation number two. So I want to see who has finished that evaluation number two. So I'm going to skip down here. Let's just see where we're at. I can click all of these, or I could just click that lock activity, and that would let me know who is finished. Just going to click all these parts of evaluation number two. And then when I have picked what I want, I'm going to click refresh. And that's just going to pull in those fields. You can choose all if you want to. Just be aware that's more data you have to sift through. So after I have decided what I would like to see, I'm going to scroll down to this section, and this is going to show me evaluation number two. You can click on this plus, and this is going to open up all of the activities and show you a percentage of what activities are done in all of those parts. So I can see like the pre-observation conference out of my staff, 75% have not started, and I can see that only 25% have completed. So I could look at all parts of that by expanding those to see what has been done in each part of this. If you continue to scroll down to the bottom, the more things you have checked at the top, the more items you will obviously see over here. This is going to show me my spreadsheet. This is going to show me my staff name. I'm going to be able to see their overall status of this plan. And then those items that I checked will appear here. It's nice. It's color-coded. You can quickly see this. If you want to have access to this information later, you can click this little icon over here, and it's going to download this as a CSV, and then you can upload that in Google Sheets or Excel. It will not come in color-coded. However, you can color-code, you can set formatting, so not started is orange, the word completed is green, in progress is blue. You can set it up any way you want to, but just be aware when you do download CSV, it is not going to come in color-coded. Just making sure you're aware of that. So, and then you could go through and you could choose more again if you would like, but that is the option for the evaluation completion report. Once again, they are both found under the staff evaluations tab. And so this is just going to show you those steps that I just went through. So remember from that reporting menu, evaluation completion, choosing that plan type and selecting what you would like to look for and just showing you what those graphs do look like. So those are just those steps, but I want to make sure you saw those on the live slide. So the next thing that we are going to go look at are the reports that you can pull from staff dashboard. There is a previous recording that has been linked about communication and group reports. Information about this will be found about the 27-minute mark, so this is a great resource for you to refer to later. Sean Bears does work for us at, or work with us from PowerSchool, and so he's done a great job of explaining these reports. So if you would like to refer to this later, you can do that. Remember, the reports are going to start about the 27-minute mark. So when you are, once again, in NACIS and you go to System Administration, you do have the option to choose Staff Dashboard. So once again, System Administration, then you're going to see Staff Dashboard, and you're going to see that you do have the option to browse staff by site. You can browse staff by demographics. You can search staff, and you can look for saved staff groups if you have created your staff groups right here. So if you've already created groups and staff groups from this one, you can pull up information on those from Staff Dashboard, but you would have to create those first before they will appear. So what would you see for each of those options? So if you're looking by site, depending on how many sites you have access to, you can narrow this down. If you are maybe a principal or an AP, you're only going to have one site appear. If you're a district administrator or if you serve multiple sites, you will see them listed over here. You can check which sites you would like to see. You can choose to have this information grouped by site. So if you don't want everybody lumped in at one time, make sure you check that box, and then that's going to allow you to separate by site. You can administrative, instructional, you could even choose support. What support is in NACIS is these are those roles that have been given access to PD in NACIS. They are not evaluated in NACIS, so, but you can search for them, and since you can search these particular dashboards will allow you to search PD sites, then that would be beneficial to pull them in as well. You can also narrow this down by search, and by search is very helpful because you can narrow this down by plan type, you can choose your location, you can choose their cycle year, you can choose who has administrator rights, but you can narrow this down and search and get those specifics down. So if you know you just want, this will be a great, I would just skip to search by site. And then if you have already created some of those groups, like we just showed you a few minutes ago, then you can go search that group. So maybe you have like a beginning teachers group. Maybe you have a resident. They have their residential license, social workers, whatever. You can go and search by those groups and pull those people in as well. So let's go ahead to our site and let's look at that. I'm going to once again go to PowerSchool. I am going, let me close this box for a minute ago. So from here, I'm going to go to System Administration. Remember, if you want to, if you know you're going to want to search for groups, remember those need to be created here first. You can make your staff groups. But I am going to go to Staff Dashboard. And I am going to go ahead and I'm going to browse by site. And I'm just going to narrow down to this site. So you'll see that I, like I said, I am in a training site. So I have my three people who are in my training site. If these, any of these three people were currently registered for any learning opportunities, they would appear. This will be like a little line graph that they would appear on. We do not use group reports. That's not going to apply to us. We do have individual information. If you wanted to look at in the individual, you can look at when they last logged in. So if you tell someone to go do something and you look and they haven't logged in a couple weeks, and you're going to know that they have not done that. You can also look at a course completion report. If you have assigned your staff to do a certain course, then maybe I've told everybody they need to do this course. You can type in the course number. You can search by anyways, but make sure if you have a course number that has just a couple numbers, you might want to put it in quotation marks so they don't pull up everything that has that number. If I click on details, my screen just went blank. Give me 1 second. Okay, so if I click on details, this is going to pull up each person, and I can see of that course whether they have completed that course or not registered for that course, or maybe not even started that course. So you can decide what you want to see. Do you want to see if they're not registered? or registered or completed, and you can narrow that down. You can click on details, and that'll pull up specific names so you can see each individual teacher's name. But you can also click summary, and that'll give you, like, I was going to say, it's not uploading just yet. The summary will give you a percentage of your staff. So if you just need percentages, that summary will just kind of tell you out of your staff what percent have done this and what percent have finished. So once you are looking for course, if you have a mandatory course that your teachers need to do, or even those groups, maybe beginning teachers have to do something, if you have a math teacher group or whatever, then this will be a way for you to go in and see if those people have done that. Also from the group dashboard, you do have the option to look at the portal. So if you will click on the portal, this is just going to show you some graphs that you can look at for your staff. And you can see all log in. So if I log in, you can see right now we've been doing a lot of training. Every time I log in, that's going to count as a login. So you'll have a line graph for login for your school. I can see here how many days it's been since my staff last logged in. I can see that right now 100% have logged in within the last 14 days. However, if you want to get specifics for your staff, if you click on this little icon right here, this is going to allow you to view that individual data. And I can see each person's name with when they last logged in within those groups. So you'll see that if it will load, you'll see that you have. So I can see that this person, it's been 0 to 14 days since they logged in, and it'll give each person's list. So you'll have an overall, not their exact information, but you will have a range of when they last logged in. Remember to see specific information, click on their name, and you can click individual. You can also just see total logins for each year and then unique logins. So if I log in once, that will appear here and you can look and see the individual information. Okay, so that is what you will find when you are searching for your staff dashboards and then those portal reports. And just remember that when you are looking at that, this gives you an overall, does not give you specific information, but clicking on this little icon will give you that. Be aware that if you are a district administrator who has the right to assume someone's identity, when you log in, that will count for a login for that person. So if you want to find out when someone last logged in, please do not impersonate them first. You would want to look at this staff dashboard view first. Just being aware that does count as a login. So we're going to go to the next part of our session today, and we are going to look at quick reports. And so when you are looking for quick reports, and there's a couple of other reports we can find from the reportings tab. So once again, from NESIS, when you click on reporting, you're going to see that you do have a drop down. We do have evaluation process that we can look at. We do have portal management, and we do have quick reports. We do not use observations and assessment. This platform is used by multiple schools, multiple states. And so some things that they use for other states are not applicable to us, but they can't remove them due to like coding or something. So you'll notice that once you click here, you click on this little drop, click on number one drop down, it will show you these options. If you would like to see what any of these reports are about, once you click on one of these and click the word here, all of the reports in that section will appear in a description of each one, so you'll know what they mean. So once again, before you click, make sure you click here so you can see what those reports are. And once again, and that is for evaluation process. It's for portal management and also for quick reports. Okay. So once you click on those quick reports or any of those reports, you are going to have to select a report to run. Please remember that this is going to, the current year is only going to pull active plans. That means someone has actually clicked start new for them to appear on this list. So just making sure you can do that. One thing that you can do is you can schedule run times, and we'll talk about scheduling reports that are going to run. You can go back and select previous years. Just remember that some of those fields will not be correct historically, because remember location type will be pulling from those current plans, so that historical information will not be accurate. So that's what's important for you to have run those at the end of each school year. And remember that all results are going to depend on what access rights you have. So So if you only have rights to your school, you're only going to see your school here. If you have access to the whole district, then you will see those reports. But just some things to think about if you have to go back and pull additional reports. I do want to give a shout out.
Donna,
yes,
your sound is going in and out, so I just want to let you know.
Thank you.
It comes right back within a few seconds, but
let me try one thing. I've tried to test that before. Thank you for letting me know. Let me try that. Does that help at all? Make it any better?
I can hear you fine right now. Yeah, you're good.
Okay. Thank you for letting me know.
Yeah. And I'm just gonna, if you guys have any questions while Donna's talking, you can type them in the chat if you have any questions. All right. Thanks, Donna.
No, thank you. I'm sorry it messed up. I don't know why it does that. Yeah. So I do want to, like I said, give a shout out that at the Paint Conference in 2021, you can see these presenters. They did a great job of showing these what reports are beneficial at different times in the school year. So I'm just borrowing the next few slides from them because they did an excellent job of showing what can be pulled at different times. So if you're in here, thank you so much. And these are like some of your NESIS experts in the state. So if you have questions and they work with you or in your district, they might be someone you could always reach out to. So some reports that they do find helpful, and I have linked their entire presentation here if you would like to go back and look at that later. I am pulling in some slides to talk about for the beginning of the year, for middle of the year, and end of the year. So once again, if you want to go straight to their presentation and look, it is linked here, but I have pulled in a couple for each section. So at the beginning of the year, some reports that would be helpful, and I know we're not at the beginning of the year now, but as you're preparing for next year, these are some reports. Orientation dates. So this is going to show if a teacher has completed that training orientation date that's required, and you know that has to be done within the first 10 days, but be aware that if they haven't started their plan, PDP activities for the current year. This PDP activity will show beginning of the year, middle and end of the year. It has a space for mentor. It has a space for signatures. At this time of, you know, at the beginning of the year, once you download that, you're not going to want to see all the information. You're really just going to want to focus at the beginning of the year part. To run any of these reports, you'll see that they do have links, some directions on how to run these quick reports. So there's directions here, and there's actually beginning of the year screenshots that you can look at to go back and help you with running those reports. So once again, to get to these reports, remember you do go to reporting. You're going to choose quick reports, and then from the drop down, you're going to want to look at orientation dates. Once you look at that, you're going to want to click the word done. Anytime you pull in a quick report, you're going to want to click in the word done. And you're going to see you immediately have some information on your screen, and that's going to be this way for all of these reports, that immediate information that pops up. If you would like to save this, you're just going to need to click download CSV. You can also click this icon, which will save as a PDF, and you'll see the information directly on your screen. But if you click this icon to save as a PDF, you cannot manipulate the data later. So if you think this is information you will want to filter and sort, you're going to want to make sure you download by CSV. Once you download the information, you can upload this into Google Sheets or you can upload this into Excel. And you can see this is an example of a beginning of the report that's already been exported. You can see that it's already been, the rows have been adjusted so you can read each piece. But now you can see, okay, this person has started their evaluation plans and you can see their orientation date and when they did that. So you're going to see that this has already been brought in and they have already pulled it. So it went from what you saw on this screen, which you have your information, and then you can pull it in this way. Also, in addition to that orientation, that record of PDP activities, and remember, this is going to pull in, we're going to talk about this for beginning of the year, middle of the year, and end of the year, but right now we're only going to find information, obviously, if you did it at the beginning of the year for that information. And you're going to be able to see the dates that they did their self-assessment. You're going to be able to see when they started that process. So that PDP activities, you're going to be able to see those years. And when they come in, you'll see that there are names that have been redacted, so you can't see those. And you're probably at this point in time of the year, you can delete these columns that talk about middle of the year because you wouldn't need that information. But once that information is downloaded, you can manipulate it however you would like. Some reports that will probably be beneficial for middle of the year. You're going to have that record of PDP activities again. This time you're going to want to make sure you're looking through the middle of the year, not just beginning of the year, middle of the year. And remember, mentor is listed on everybody's plan, but it's not required for everyone. So just be aware you're going to see mentor. It is not one of those fields that has an asterisk beside it to make sure that it is required, but you are going to see it listed as a column. Just because it's blank doesn't mean someone had to have it. So you can go through and just look at those people who have to have mentors. Another report that would be beneficial is the evaluation completion exception report for current year. And that's going to show observation progress and your summative evaluation progress. So that's going to pull your current year's data for where they're at. But remember, they have to have a current plan. They had to start. And also users who have more than one active plan. So you're going to want to make sure your teachers don't have additional plans assigned to them. If they do, that plan would need to be deactivated because we don't want them to start on more than one plan. Once again, on the screen, they were awesome when they created their presentation. They did link some step-by-step directions and screenshots to help you with these running these reports. So if you're running, again, that record of a PDP activity, you can see that they kind of highlighted in yellow things that were missing because they did that formatting. Any cell that was blank, they wanted to turn yellow so we can see where these are missing. You can see that they also removed all the end of year information because you don't need that information at the beginning of, at the middle of the year. You can see this evaluation completion report. This is going to pull in their plan type. You're going to see comprehensive. You're going to see abbreviated. You're going to see standard. You can also make sure that when you filter this, that top line is a label column or label on row. So you could do that. But you can see if it's completed, and you can also see if it's not started. And once again, you can see that they did color code this so that anything not started does show up in yellow, because middle of year, you're going to want observation number one, observation number two to be completed. And you can see that they didn't, when they filtered this, they didn't pull in everything. They just looked at certain parts. I'm also looking for people who have more than one plan assigned to them. So if you're seeing someone who has more than one plan assigned to them, you're going to need to decide what plan needs to be deactivated so they do not have access to that. If you do have to deactivate a plan, just make sure any information that needs to be included, the person would need to work with their evaluator to copy any information that would need to be moved over to the other plan. So just making sure you're aware of that. And then once you have the information that you need, deactivate the plan that is not correct. But that is a great report to help you identify those. Some end of year reports that you would want to look at, that record of PDP activities again, because we're looking for end of year. We want to make sure that it's filled in all the way across. That evaluation completion exception report again, we're going to look through to the end of the year. Still looking at users who have more than one plan. We want to make sure that we've cleared any of that up. And then the evaluation summary reports for all plan types. That's something reports you're going to need for the end of the school year. So looking again, step-by-step directions are listed here again, and as well as those screenshots. So once again, we're looking now for PDP activities. We're looking for that end of year information. And remember, once you pull this in, you can manipulate it any way you would like. You can narrow it down by school and looking at those cells that are not completed. And that evaluation completion report for those observations, kind of looking at, once again, that's not started, what is started. If someone has a peer observation, that's going to pull in. But remember, everybody does not have to have a peer. So just because someone's is blank doesn't mean that they have to have one there. It'll say not started if it needs to happen. And then also, you have those summary evaluations for the end of the year and looking at if that summary evaluation has been completed for those different plan types. At the end of the year, these are some reports you would probably want to run to make sure you have access to them. Remember, doing this before the end of the school year, because we want that historical information to be correct with that plan type. So you're going to want to look at the career development, the evaluation completion, media coordinators, maybe mentor relationship, observation start and time, PDP, peer observations, principal, AP, psychologists, evaluation school counselors, social workers, the abbreviated plan, comprehensive, standard, late hire, teacher leadership, technology facilitators, all of those that you're going to want to run as soon as they're completed at your school, but before that last official day of the year. And we're asking you to do that again this year by the 28th of June. So just making sure you have access to those plans that do need to be run. And when you run, you do have the option for that evaluation summary report. You can just look at those overall standards once you manipulate that data if you just want to see that. Or you can have a report that actually lists each element as well. So it's how you want to look at that and how you want to manipulate that data. It's just being aware that once you do download those, you have a lot of options there. Remember, district administrators are able to run these all of these reports to see those and those element rates. So I'm going to go and show you how to get all of those reports. I showed you some reports that would be helpful. As you run any report, and I'll model this for you once we go in, you can memorize any report that you know that you're going to need. You can actually set those up to run as well as to schedule those to run weekly or monthly or however you need to do that. So let's just go look at a report and make sure that we schedule that report so we can run that report and even memorize that report. So the two or one of the two reports that I'm going to look at is I get a lot of emails about people being in NESIS who shouldn't be there. So maybe you had someone who left your district and they are still showing up in your reports, or you have someone who came to your district and they're still showing up as belonging to another district. And we are working, I know we've been sending out information in our bulletin to show you how to clean up NESIS, but this is a very beneficial report to have, especially if staff leave and come and go during the school year. So I'm going to look at individuals who belong to more than one district. So I want to look at individuals who belong to sites in more than one district. So, in order to do that, I'll come back here. Make sure the screen is big. So, in order to do that, I am going to go to reporting. Remember, this is where I showed you that in the picture that you're going to choose this option. I'm going to go down to quick reports. I'm going to go to individuals who belong to sites in more than one district. So this should not happen. We do not want these people to appear in their previous district, or if someone leaves our district, we want to make sure that that has been handled so they have been removed. So once I have decided what report I want to run, I am going to click the word done. And I am going to, you can memorize this report or you can go ahead and download this as a CSV. I don't think I have anyone to show. I'm sorry about that. But this is going to show you someone who belongs in more than one district. Apparently, the ones I have do not. But you can memorize this report. Give it a report name that makes sense to you. So individuals who belong to more than one district, I can memorize this. And then when I want to come back later and see this report, I've already memorized it. I don't have to search for it from the list. So in order to find that, I'm going to go to reporting. And then when you scroll down, you'll see any reports that you have memorized. And you can run those at any time. So it's already ready to go. You can click run. You don't have to search for it from the list. You can also, like I said, manage reports to run. So maybe monthly you want to keep a check on if any new staff have come. Maybe their previous district has not made them inactive in staff UID and they're still showing up for their old district and your district. So I want to manage this particular report and I want to make sure that I schedule this to run on a monthly basis. I can make sure that NESIS stays clean. So I'm going to click on schedule a quick report. And I'm going to create scheduled quick report. And then this is that drop down list. Individuals who belong to sites in more than one district. You're going to have to give it a name. So this is training. You have to give it a file name for where it's going to go. So I'm just going to give it a name. You have to give it an export date. You have to give it a time. If you forget a field and you try to complete the report, it's going to tell you what error or maybe you missed. Maybe I do want this monthly and I want this to run on the first day of the month, and I want this to run every month. I want this to end. You can choose by the end of the school year. You can choose. And then you have to set up an email address. So I can go ahead and set this up. All of this FTP information, please do not touch that. That is not something we use. I don't want you to get any error messages. So just leave those as is once you enter the email address. And then I can add. So this is going to appear here on this list. Now, every quick report that has been scheduled to run, you're going to see here. You can't touch them. You can't manipulate them. You can only have a box beside the ones that you created. So if you see reports other people have run here, you can just see them, but you can't touch them. You can, if you wanted to delete yours, you can come here, click, check the box, and you could delete your report. And they are in alphabetical order. So you can see those from this list. But then from this point forward, you're going to get an email whatever day you set it to come through. And remember, that was done on the reporting tab. These are reports I've memorized. I could click run, but I could also manage and just have that scheduled to come in at any time. So those that report would be very beneficial. And then if you have staff that move within your own district, you can look at individuals who belong to more than one site within your district. So those reports will probably be very, very beneficial to help you clean up your NESIS and then making sure that if you have staff leave your site, that they are removed as well. And these are those steps again that you can do that. Remember, you're going to go to manage reports, schedule a quick report, and schedule that. Remember to leave all of those FTP fields blank. And like I said, you're going to see others' reports that are there, but you can only delete your own. So you can't touch theirs. It's just in that list. And as you're managing those, you can remember reports, my reports container, and you can see all of those that you already have scheduled. So you already have all of those there. And so just a reminder again to make sure that you do finish all plans prior to June 28th this year, just because that's on a Friday and nobody wants to work on the weekend. They have to make sure they get that done. Make sure that those quick reports are run by current year if you want to get those, you know, those rating information. Make sure you're notifying NESIS district administrators when they can run those end of year reports. Remember some helpful things you might want to look at, that staff evaluation completion report. There's summary rating quick reports. There's a record of activities. These are just some suggestions of things that you're probably going to want to run prior to that date, because once the school year is over, that, like I said, that historical information may not be correct. So make sure I go ahead and talk to you about if you would like to receive a certificate for today or give us feedback for today. So this is going to show you our region. You do need your region information in order to get credit. So go ahead and take a quick look at this map and find your county. And that's going to tell you what district or region that you are in. I'll give you just a second to look at that. And after you find your region or your district, this screen is going to have access to our feedback form. And from this form, you, if you want, a certificate of attendance today. The last two questions will allow you to add information for that. You can, if you have a phone in your hand, you're welcome to scan that QR code and you can immediately just fill that out. I'm also going to put this link in the chat. So if you just wanted to go straight to that feedback form, that is in the chat as well, because we love your feedback. We would appreciate that. And if you want a certificate, you will need to fill that out. Excuse me, click too far. So the next thing I want to show you is if you have not had a chance to check out our NESIS resource site, this is going to be information where you find all of our policies and our information. You can click on each circle to go specifically for teacher information, principal information, support staff. It's going to include staff that are evaluated in NESIS and those that are not. You'll find information about both. Central office staff, superintendent staff, you'll find information about webinars, but this is a very good site for that policy information and additional resources. If you've never had a chance, if you are an admin and you are one who does all of these reportings and all of these observations or evaluations, if you have not yet joined our NESIS Admin Resource Hub, that is a great resource. It has information for beginning of the year, middle of the year, end of the year, reporting, troubleshooting. In order to access that, you will need to click on the blue NESIS icon from NC EdCloud. So sign into the Blue Canvas icon in NC EdCloud. Once you get in on the global navigation, all the way on the very bottom left, you may have to scroll to see it. You're going to see home-based resources, and then you're going to want to find NESIS, and then click on NESIS, and that's going to give you access. If you've never been before, it's going to ask you to enroll in the course. If you have enrolled before, it's going to ask you to go. Once you have been once, it's going to allow you, you'll see this appear on your Canvas dashboard, and you won't have to enroll again. So if you have not used that, that site has lots of information. It's very, very beneficial for you as you are navigating NESIS. Also, we have a few more webinars that are going on this year. I do have all of them linked here. We're going to have one in a couple weeks on ad hoc reporting. We're going to do that on November 21st. And then we're going to have one on managing local PD, utilizing playlists, and then some end of the year webinars. So if any of those will be beneficial, then you can do that. We also have our YouTube playlist. So every time we do webinars, we do upload those. You're very welcome. We do upload those webinars, those videos that you can see those, and we have been putting those on the webinar sheet. So after this recording next week, I'll make sure I get a copy of it and link the presentation in this video. So thank you so much for joining us. If you have any questions at all about anything after today, you're welcome to reach out to me.